Hello everyone, I Dr. Sanjay Kumar Srivastav, faculty of BHMC from Technical Institute of Advanced Studies. Today I am going to deliver a lecture on the topic of radio as medium of mass communication. Radio programming is undergoing intense metamorphosis these days, keeping in view the challenges thrown by 24 hours television programming. In the recent years, there is a quantum jump in the media channels, particularly TV channels. Most of them are commercial channels dishing out entertainment programs. Since television offers multifaceted and multifarious fare on national network in a commercialized media entertainment, radio receives less attention. However, some positive developments have taken place which hold great future for radio broadcasting. One such major development in the field of radio in this country is the end of government's monopoly of the airways. The demand for permission to establish private channel has been made from time to time, but the Supreme Court gave the landmark judgment that the airways cannot be controlled solely by the government with the setting of the Prasar Bharati Broadcasting Corporation. There is a change in the situation. The advent of private radio broadcasting has become a reality. Radio is the transmission of signals by modulation of electromagnetic waves with frequencies below those of visible lights. In electronic modulation is the process of varying one or more properties of high frequency periodic waveforms called the carrier signals with respect to our modulating signals. This is done in similar fashion as a musician by modulate the tone from a musical instrument by varying its volume, timing and pitch. The three key parameters of a periodic waveform are its amplitude, its phase and its frequency, all of which can be modified in according with a low frequency signal to obtain the modulated signal. During the 1930s, radio was considered an intimate and credible medium. The public used it as a news source and expected it to provide factual information. Radio was the first truly mass medium of communication, reaching millions of people instantly and altering social attitude, family relationships, and how people related to their environment. Radio is an attractive medium among the various mass communication media because of its special characteristics. It continues to be as relevant and potent as it was in the early years despite the emergence of more glamorous media. It is tourism that in the first phase of broadcasting, spanning three decades from the early 20s, radio resigned alone or was the dominant player. However, a period of time, the media since has changed drastically. Television, with its inherent strength of audiovisual component, has captured the imagination of the people. The advent of the satellite television, the internet, and the convergence of technology have added further dimensions in media utilization pattern. However, despite the presence of a plethora of media, there is room and scope for each medium. Experience has revealed that new technologies added things on, but they don't replace. One medium is not displaced by another. Each medium reinvents itself in the context of changes in the communication environment. In the changed media scenario, radio is reorienting itself with more innovative program and formats. So I hope you understand the topic of radio as medium of mass communication. Thank you very much.